In this video, we are going to discuss the BPM, beats per minute, beat matching, and the tempo functionality within the trakAxPC mixing window and individual tracks. When you open up a new mixing window, the global BPM will be defaulted to 120 BPM. This means all the audio within this mix will be played at 120 BPM. If you wish to change this tempo to increase or decrease the tempo of the mix, either highlight the tempo field and type in your new tempo, or simply adjust the tempo pad situated beside the tempo field with your mouse. I already have a mix open and I'm going to press play and hear the mix played at 120 BPM. As you can hear, this mix plays a little fast. This is because the files within the mix are at a lower tempo. You can find the detected BPMs of files in a number of ways. Firstly, you can right-click on the file in the media browser and select Properties. The Properties window will appear and display the BPM as well as any tags attached to that file. For example, this hip-hop loop that I'm using in my mix is an acetized file and being detected at 90 BPM. Another way to detect the BPM of a file is to click on the Bpm Parameters icon situated in the track properties. When clicked, the Bpm Parameters window will appear. In this window, you can also see the detected BPM. BPM detection is not an exact science, and trakax may occasionally detect a different BPM figure. Usually, this difference is by a factor of 2. This may occur when the file does not contain a tag or when it's a short loop. You can override this by clicking on the Multiply by 2 box, Divide by 2 box, or the Multiply by 1 box to create a new BPM for that file. If you wish to restore the BPM to its original tempo, click on the Restore to Default button. Because trakax is stretching files in order to beat sync them, you can adjust the stretching engine to improve the quality of the file. If you bring a piece of audio into the mixing window and it just doesn't sound quite right, switching to high quality will improve the stretching of the file. Just to note, improving a large number of files to high quality may affect its performance on lower spec machines. We'll now close out of this window and open up a new mix regarding the BPM parameters. With the introduction of the new crossfading feature, you now have the ability to crossfade multiple files on the same track. In this mix, I have 4 files crossfaded on the same track. However, if you click on the BPM parameters icon, it will only show the BPM parameters of the first track. But don't worry, you can access the BPM parameters of all files within the track by clicking on the segment properties of the individual file. This icon resembles a penknife. The BPM parameters icon is located in the toolbar beside the preserve pitch. Click on it and the BPM window will appear. I can also view the BPM in the tempo field. We'll now close out of this window. We'll now move back into our previous mix. From the numerous ways we have checked the detected BPM of our loops, we've discovered they are in and around 90 BPM. We'll now change the global tempo to match 90 BPM. I'll click play to listen to it. This sounds spot on.